On that dreaded August anniversary, I wanted to turn back to a time when my life was not like the dead garden that lay before me. My childhood home now seems distant and fleeting, a beautiful dream that could no longer be. Closing my eyes, I would return to my father's garden, sheltered from the shadows behind the mountain range. Through grandmother's silence, I first came to see what our lives were destined to be. Through memories, she searched for a home lost to war and to the passage of time. Through her mirror, she held on to the beauty and strength within herself, even in trying times. And in my grandmother's eyes, I saw the loneliness and sorrow women have to endure for freedom. On that August night, grandmother left her life behind. Violets pressed inside books, shadows of broken dreams. And only mother's uncompromising strength could tear us from the home and lives we dreamt for ourselves. Nothing remained but the memory of the approaching sounds of war. Since that night in the refugee camp, I have often found comfort in the shadows of olive trees. As mother searched for help, grandmother drifted away. My home was buried beyond the mountain range. And my brother's gaze fell into the sea. For years, I awaited father's return from the war, until the day my brother sailed away on a merchant ship. I looked to mother for strength, but she resigned herself to silence. My brother surrendered to the fluidity of water and fate, not wanting to delude himself, wishing for roots in soil. I couldn't escape the mountain range beyond which my life was held captive. In my weekly visits with mother, I feared her silence. Until the August anniversary, when I filled her house with a life that could never be. Like mother, I surrendered to isolation, for nothing remained but the garden that died inside me. In the weeks that followed, I did not visit mother. Beyond the edge of my garden, I distinguished the hazy line that separates past and present, life and death, us and them. Thank you. When I was finally convinced that Mother was no longer part of my life, she came into my house, forming the sign of the cross with the smoke of burning olive leaves. As we dug the dead roots from the ground, Mother broke the silence, shared her memories of Grandmother's lost home and of the father she barely knew. She remembered Grandmother's love for violets, sheltered from sunlight under the shadow of trees. Strong women, like Grandmother, often appear fragile, like violets on the outside. In our loves and losses, we were all the same, Grandmother, Mother, and me. We are bound to the land by memories, by our sense of the soil. Mothers and daughters of war protect ourselves in shadows, just like Grandmother's violet garden. Though the past we can never forget, for our children, we will always grow new gardens, new memories.